Welcome to Basic Data Entry for Archives in ICMS. This course will teach you the basics of entering data in the various types of fields and attaching images in the Interior Museum Collection Management Program with a focus on the Archives module. The basic navigation and the data entry for cultural resources video courses are prerequisites for this training. All of the information we'll cover in this course is also available in several other places. Chapter 1 of the ICMS User Manual covers system basics, including how to navigate the Archives module. Chapter 6 covers data entry. All DOI units using ICMS should already have a copy of the manual. It is also available in PDF format on the Rediscovery FTP site, ftp.rediscov.com/ICMS, and on the DOI Museum Program website, www.doi.gov/museum/ICMS. We strongly recommend you refer to the user manual as you begin to use ICMS. Also, the online system help describes all of the program's functions. Let's get started. After login, you'll start at the home page. From the home page, you can go anywhere in the program. Some functions are available immediately from the home page. Others are available only when you're working with records in the database. One function available from anywhere is the System Help. It includes a chapter on data entry. The data entry chapter explains how to add records and how to use all the different types of fields. Under Modules, there are several sections related to the Archives, including how to navigate the Archives hierarchy. The Index tab in System Help is especially useful. If you cannot remember what chapter contains the information you need, click on the Index tab and enter the subject, for example, Field Types. Now we'll learn about data entry for archives. From the home page, you can go anywhere using the keyboard or the mouse or a combination. Navigate to the Cultural Resources directory and into Catalog Records. To add a collection to the Archives module, start in the Cultural Resources Catalog Records. Enter the record as usual using the proper classification for an archival collection. Class 1 is History, followed by Communication Artifacts, Documentary Artifact, and Archival Manuscript Collection. The object field is the collection title. Also complete the fields on the Archives tab. Local collection number must be filled in and becomes the collection number in the Archives module. Most of the fields on the Archives tab also transfer to the Archives module. Refer to the Quick Reference section in the ICMS User Manual for additional help with these fields. When complete, click Save and Close. Note that only a Cultural Resources Catalog record is required for museum accountability. This record describes the contents and size of the archival collection. When necessary, and especially for large archival collections, you should create a more detailed description by using the Archives module in ICMS. Archival description is different than object cataloging. There only should be one catalog record for an archival collection as a whole, regardless of how many documents it contains or how many accessions might have been combined to create a provenance-based collection. But the single collection-level catalog record also needs more detailed descriptions based on the collection's unique hierarchical structure to meet archival standards. That's what we'll cover now. To send this record to the Archives module, modify it. Click the Modify button, or choose Modify from the Edit menu, or press F10. Click the Send to Archives module link to send this record to the Archives module. Navigate to the Archives 4-level directory and to Collections. Note the collection level record you've just transferred from the Cultural Resources Catalog record. It has the same collection number, catalog number, title, etc. All of these data were transferred from the Cultural Resources record. This is the starting place for a more detailed description of the collection using the Archives module. The Edit menu includes functions for adding, modifying, copying, and deleting records. Note that the function keys are also available: F9 to add a record, F10 to modify a record, for example. Some of these edit functions are only available if you're in an editing mode, like undo, cut, copy, and paste, and some are available only when you have selected specific records, as with a tag or filter. Now we'll add subrecords to this collection. Subrecords provide additional information in a hierarchical arrangement. Click the Series Subrecords tab, or press Ctrl-N to go to the next tab. Ctrl-R goes to the previous tab. This collection already has several series within it, but we'll add one more. Click the Add link to add another series within the collection. A new window opens with blank fields. The collection number is automatically filled in. Enter a series number. You can also include subseries by including a period in the number. The same rule applies to subcollections. A period in the number indicates a sublevel within the main level. Also, zero padding in the series or subseries number 002, 005, 010, etc. is very important to ensure proper numerical ordering. Press Tab to move from field to field. Note how the field help changes as you move from field to field. The field help tells you what kind of data to enter into each field and how to enter it. Enter a location where this series is stored. The catalog number and accession number fields are optional, since they're already indicated on the collection level record that contains this series. Note that an archival collection can, and often does, contain multiple accessions, and that you can add new accessions after initial cataloging is completed. Your goal is to bring together all materials made or received by a single records creator, such as a refuge or park, under a single catalog record. Enter the series title. This is a memo field allowing unlimited text, but your text should be brief, descriptive, and not repeat information from the overall collection title. If you capitalize the title in this field, it is easier to read and navigate through when you later print out the finding aid. The Scope field is a formatted memo. Press F12 to expand it to see the subfields. Enter information about the contents, nature, and extent of the series. Click Save and Close to close this window. Complete the other fields as appropriate. Remember that archival descriptions follow a hierarchy from top to bottom. Do not repeat information on the series level that is already contained on the collection level record. Click Save and Close to save the series record you've added. The Track Changes window opens. It includes history tracking supplemental records, just like cultural resources and natural history catalog records. In this case, enter a reason for the location update, then click OK to save the record. Note that the list of series subrecords for collection 3003 now include this series 009 record we've just added. Click the Use These Records option to use and view the series level records for this collection. Note that we're now viewing the series level screen, and the list shows us only series records for this collection. Note that the status bar tells me there is a hierarchical range active, showing only records for collection 3003. The status bar also tells me the number of records within that range. There are several other ways to add subrecords. For example, to add file unit subrecords to this series, you could click the File Unit Subrecords tab and click Add, as we've just done to add the series subrecord to the collection. Or view the hierarchy and use the Edit menu or right-click menu to add a new file unit subrecord. Or go directly to the file unit level using the navigator and then click the Add button on the button bar. The first two options will automatically fill in the collection and series numbers for you. The third option will not. Since we've already added a series level record, we may want to add a file unit record within it. In this case, I'll choose the File Unit Subrecords tab and click Add there. A file unit record opens in a separate window with the collection and series numbers already filled in. Enter a file unit number and tab to title. Enter a brief title for this file unit. The Dates field and Summary Note field are also important to fill in. Click Save and Close to save the record, and you're returned to the previous screen showing the file unit level record you just added. Choose Use These Records, and now we're viewing the file units within the series, within the collection we started with. In this case, there is only one file unit level record we've just added. The status bar tells me there's one record and indicates a hierarchical range of the file units within the collection 3003, series 009. On the Hierarchical Parents tab, we can see the parent records of this file unit. These are hot links, so I can click on the series or collection parent to go to that record. We'll click on the collection level record to demonstrate. It takes us to the collection level record. Only from the collection level, you can create a finding aid document for an archival collection. From the record menu, at the bottom, choose Finding Aid SGML. You can choose from several templates, such as a finding aid with file unit. Click Browse to choose a folder to store the output file, such as your My Documents folder, and enter a file name. Click OK to generate the finding aid. When complete, click Cancel to close this window. The resulting file will be found in the folder you selected with the file name you gave it. The file type is RTF, which stands for Rich Text Document. This type of file can be opened with Word, usually by simply double-clicking the file. You can email this file to anyone who would like to research the collection. Currently in ICMS, only MPS has defined templates for archival finding aids. Anyone can use them and edit the header in Word to be specific to your bureau or office. Additional templates can be added as needed when specified by a bureau or office. Returning to the file unit record we added, I'll show you how to attach images to records. On the Images tab, you can view and attach image files to catalog records. Choose Import Image Files to select one or more image files to attach to this catalog record. You can select several at a time if needed using Shift or Control keys. If you have many image files for a single record and all the image files are in one folder, choose Import Image Folder to attach them all at once. We are now at the end of this training. Remember to use the System Help and the ICMS User Manual. If you need technical support for ICMS, contact Rediscovery at the phone or email shown on the Help menu under About Rediscovery.